old 27-foot Terry Quantum rear bath couples coach here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan, 6,430 pounds. And you know what? Not bad shape. I mean, it's an 05. She's used, but not in terrible condition. Does look like she was stored outside, but it does look like it was maintained properly. Where I base that on the fact here is, like, you can see some weathering of decals, and on an 05, frankly, that doesn't surprise me. And frankly, I've seen much worse on something that's much, much newer. You'll notice that's only on the darker decals, though. The darker decals generate more heat and will tend to curl a little bit more quickly. But I can't detect any leaks in it, so that tells me it was maintained properly. Plus, it's clean. I mean, they did keep it clean here. Now, I've seen a couple areas where the fiberglass skin has come loose from the body a little bit. Now, keep in mind, guys, I'm going out of my way to show you this because chances are, from just a quick video, you never would have noticed it. We're very transparent and very honest in our sales regimen around here. This is not water damage, because if it was, that would be soft underneath. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just, think of, like, if you steam a stamp off an envelope, it bubbles and it just kind of pops off. Around the high stress points, like where the floor meets the wall and the box twists a lot, it just kind of wiggled loose a little bit, but structurally the trailer's still sound. Visually, it still looks fine too. There's nothing really wrong with it there. Big wide baggage compartment means you can get some nice, like, big folding zero gravity chairs in here. You see that does pass all the way through nicely. And I do like the little toolbox chest right here. That's a neat little touch. You don't see that done very much anymore. Full nose cap, which was, it's becoming just all the rage right now on laminated trailers, putting a full nose cap on here. But when this was built, that was not very common. It really did identify and signify this one as something beyond entry level. Power tongue jack was added on here, and it looks like it was replaced not too long ago. The weathering on the paint of the tongue jack looks far newer and doesn't quite match that of the tongue down here. I don't know if that's really translating to video, but long story short, that tongue jack should serve you for a while. You see the slide-on awning cover there? It's probably one of the reasons that there is no sign or any trace of any sort of water damage or penetration around the slide, because that thing absorbs and deflects the brunt of the rough weather stuff straight off the trailer. Now, above the rear bathroom, they've got a max air cover on the roof so that you can keep the vent open even when it's raining. A little outside utility shower, little stuff like that. Now, I noticed they have a sticker here. These folks traveled. This thing's been almost everywhere. It's been to, looking at the map that they have on the side, probably about 40 of the 50 states. I mean, this thing's been around. So, you know, they've used it. They had their eyes on it. They took good care of it. But one of the stickers I noticed, it says Gooseberry Falls. My dad used to have a different meaning for the phrase gooseberries to try to trick the kids into having to wash our hands. I'll just leave it at that. So hopefully that park there in Canada is it's named after something else. Moving forward, I'm sorry if I'm a little monotone, more than usual today. I was up late trying to get caught up, trying to get a lot of inventory put online, and still not quite shaking the cobwebs out. Inside does not disappoint, and actually has a couple. This is kind of built in between a phase where it's got some classic features, but you still see the generation of modern edge that was coming into it. Let me back up here and explain what I mean. So, I mean, at one point, Fleetwood dominated like 75% of the RV market. They were the kings, and they were just really, like, you look at this floor plan and you're like, well, they still make campers like this. What's the big deal? And that's my point. They still make campers just like this one, because it was so far ahead of its time that 12 years later, this is still the way that people are generally going about it. You know, full super slide with storage overhead. You generally don't see storage overhead in trailers nowadays. All those extra little things Fleetwood did made them so popular, like the little reading pocket and map pocket, or, you know, magazine pocket right here in the back of the dinette. Little stuff like that cost a couple extra cents, but it all adds up. There is storage below the dinette, and there are drawers to get to it down here. Obviously, the dinette can fold down into a sleeper. That's a full-on hide-a-bed, by the way. But this is an interesting, this is one of those classic things I was telling you about. Classic Fleetwood. They have the individual, for lack of a better phrase, dad's chair is how I often heard it referred to growing up. Before RVs had slide outs, they used to stretch them out really long. Well, that usually meant there was a big open space by the door, so they would put a single rocking chair right here. Well, as trailers, they got a little bit shorter, but then they got wider with the slide out. But that chair stuck around for a little bit. Eventually, it was phased out, probably due to cost aggression reasons, but it's still here, it's still present. And this is the chair that came with and was intended for this unit. You can see it matches the decor perfectly. That is factory spec chair right there. So there's a couple different things you can do with it. You can either leave it right there so that you have a pretty solid shot at the entertainment center. But what I was thinking of is during the day, it probably wouldn't be terrible to have it sitting right here facing inward. It would be very social. It would kind of segregate the bedroom a little more. In today's world, we prefer to have a little more privacy in the bedroom of our campers. When this was built, it just wasn't a big deal to folks, really. Moving on, we've got central air, central heat, great spring, summer, fall camper. And, I mean, again, you know, you can see where they had, you know, they'd clean the countertops and the sinks are clean and everything. I like that folding stove cover for extra counter space. I mean, they took care of this. They did a good job. I saw where they had replaced the air conditioner filter at one point. I mean, you know, little stuff. They took care of it. Now, something Fleetwood was just the best at was just good kitchen storage. You've got 6 drawers, a couple of them pretty darn big. You've got good cabinet space, more cabinet space above. These are all raised panel type doors, really sharp. Now we've also got a really big pantry next to an 8 cubic foot refrigerator freezer. That is still not even really common and standard in today's market. We actually carry a couple brands here that will standardize that at this product level. But when this was built, that was like a fifth wheel only feature here in a travel trailer. And though you look at this trailer today through today's lens and say, well, I mean, it just seems normal, but it's 12 years old. It seems standard by today's standards. 12 years ago, this thing was cutting edge. It was top of its class. That's what you got to kind of remember here. I do like this big pantry, and it's wide. You could also use it as a closet. There's hangers up there. You can adjust these shelves, I mean, exactly to the pinpoint level you're looking for. And I love those classic mesh little drawer things there. I don't know what you want to call them, but they work great, and they're simple, they're inexpensive, and they're functional. Full 8-foot wide rear bathroom, you know, plenty of shower space. We got the skylight overhead, they even include like a little extra curtain rod here depending on, like, if you're one of those people who doesn't use the bathroom, you could easily use this as extra hanging storage for clothing. Again, just nicer little visual feature, the floating mirror style mirror. It actually is a medicine cabinet, but a big darn sink an adult can actually get their hands in. This is a grown-up person's camper. Foot flush stool, back at a time where that was not super, super common, and just a truckload of storage back here. This extra closet is everything. If you're one of those folks that took extended trips, this is the one for you. Now remember, this power vent up here does have a max air cover on it, so you can leave this thing open and ventilating. And that's this camper in a nutshell. It's a solid shape little bugger. At worst, you might have to dust something real quick. It's ready to go. And just because of the age, you're not going to go broke buying this one, you know. Its depreciation cycle is done. At this point, the only thing that determines its value is your personal care and maintenance. And the previous owners did it right. I'm willing to bet you could too. So give us a call. Learn a little bit more. 800-256-5196. We're Haylett RV. We're in Coldwater, Michigan. We publish our pricing right outright. If you want to know what this runs, I leave a link in the video description down here for you to click on. It'll take you right to our used travel trailer page where you can see what we have, what we're asking, and you can learn more about them. We do trades, financing. I mean, we obviously do trades. That's how we got this one. But, we can deliver this right to a campsite. If you don't intend on towing, we can put it in your driveway. You can put it at your campsite. We can do anything. We just need the opportunity. So give us a call. And we'll get you there. 800-256-5196. Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Thank you very much. Take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.